Can you see how many Hamzat Wasl there are in this ayah? Well, there are four. That's 1, 2, 3, and 4. Have you noticed that every single Hamzat Wasl in the Holy Quran doesn't have any vowel on top or under it? There is no tashkeel whatsoever on any of them? Well, that shouldn't be a problem because Hamzat Wasl has this sign, which is a small sad and stands for the word wasl, and it means connect, which means that if I continue on reading, I won't have to pronounce Hamzat Wasl anyway. So I can just simply read, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا ارْكَعُوا وَاسْجُدُوا وَاعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ. So I read the ayah, I didn't have to know any tashkeel or short vowels whatsoever. Well, this solution that you connect Hamzat Wasl with what comes before it is a very good solution. But what if you want to start at this word, which means that you will have to pronounce Hamzat Wasl? Or if you want to start at that word, or this, what are you going to do then? Or even better, if Hamzat Wasl, like in this example, came at the beginning of an ayah, which means that it's much less likely that you're going to connect it with what comes before it, because we usually stop at the end of an ayah and we start at the beginning of an ayah. How are you going to pronounce this Hamzat Wasl then? Are you going to put Dhamma on top of the Hamzat Wasl and say Anzur? Or are you going to put Fatha and say Anzur? Or are you going to put Kasr and say Inzur? How can you know which one is correct? The key to answer this question is the third letter of the word. If the third letter has Dhamma on top, this means that Hamzat Wasl will also have Dhamma. So let's have another look at the example we showed at the beginning and try again. Now we see that the third letter indeed has Dhamma on top of it. So this means that the proper pronunciation for this ayah is as follows. انظر كيف يفترون على الله الكذب. Now let's have a look at another example. وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ اعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ. Notice that when I connected the Hamzat Wasl to what comes before it, I completely ignored it, but when I started at it, I pronounced Hamzat Wasl and I added Dhamma on top of it because the third letter, the word U'budu, the ba has Dhamma on top of it, so this means that we will say U'budu. Next, if the third letter has Kasra, this means that Hamzat Wasl will also get Kasra, like in these examples. اصبر على ما يقولون أن اقذفيه في التابوت اقذفيه في التابوت استكبارا في الأرض ومكر السيء. So as you can see, the third letter of each of these words has a kasra under it. So that's why when I started at the word, I will have to put kasra under Hamzat Wasl and I'll pronounce it fully because I started at the word. Next, if the third letter has fatha, then Hamzat Wasl will still get kasra, like in these examples.
Ya bunayya irkam ma'ana irkam ma'ana إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ اسْتَكْبَرَ وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ اسْتَكْبَرَ وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ امْتَحَنَ اللَّهُ قُلُوبَهُمْ لِلتَّقْوَىٰ امْتَحَنَ اللَّهُ قُلُوبَهُمْ لِلتَّقْوَىٰ.
So each of these words has fatha on top of the third letter, and therefore the Hamzat Wasl will receive kasra under it. Last, if Hamzat Wasl is part of the definite article al, in this case it will always get fatha on top of it, like in these examples.
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen Ar-Rahmanir Rahim.
So when it is part of al, I will always put fatha on top of Hamzat Wasl. So you might also wonder, why can't we just add tashkil or short vowel on top of Hamzat Wasl to solve the problem before it's even created? The reason why this is not possible is that if a letter has tashkil or short vowel on top of it, it will give the indication that it must be pronounced at all times, since there is a vowel on top of it. On the other hand, Hamzat Wasl is meant to be dropped, and actually it is dropped much more often than it is pronounced. In fact, it is dropped so often that sometimes it completely disappears in some words. Like in the famous example of Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Here we see that the first word is actually not just one word, there are two words, which mean in the name of. And originally it was written like bi, which means with or in, and followed by the word ism, which means name. So bism will then mean in the name of. But because it is always dropped in this position, and it is written like this in the Holy Quran, it is kind of disappeared. And this is not the only example with the same case. The verb is'al, which is the imperative form of ask, originally starts with Hamzat Wasl, but in the Holy Quran it is dropped like that, and it is pronounced as
was'alhum 'anil qaryati allati.
Here again, the original form of this word has Hamzat Wasl on top of it. One more thing. This is one of the most common combinations in the Holy Quran that involves Hamza and is followed by an Alif. So you gotta pay attention to the difference between Hamza and Alif, because these are two different letters. And to pronounce it correctly, you need to combine Hamzat Qata and follow it with a long vowel of Alif, like in these examples.
يَا بَنِي آدَمَ قَدْ أَنزَلْنَا سَأَصْرِفُ عَنْ آيَاتِي فَكَيْفَ آسَى عَلَىٰ قَوْمٍ كَافِرِينَ.
Notice the difference between Hamza in the word سَأَصْرِف and how it's a little bit extended when it is followed by Alif in the same ayah, but a little bit further in the word ayati. So we say سَأَصْرِفُ عَنْ آيَاتِ. We extend it a little bit longer when it is followed by the long vowel alif. And you should not mix it up with this. Here we have one Hamza after the other, and on the other side we have Hamza plus alif that we just talked about. And that is the difference in the pronunciation.
يَا عِيسَى بْنَ مَرْيَمَ أَأَنْتَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا.
Notice how I said أَأَنْتَ, because I have Hamza one after the other, so I will have to say أَأَ. But in the second example, we have Hamza followed by Alif, and for this reason, I'll have to extend it a little bit and say آمنوا. Here's another example with the same comparison.
قال أأسجد لمن خلقت طينا ولقد آتينا موسى تسع آيات بينات.
So in short, the tashkil of Hamzat Wasl can get fatha only if it is part of al, the definite article, can get dhamma if the third letter has dhamma on top and will get kasra in all other cases. Thanks for watching. I hope you've learned something new today. If you did, please like and share the video for other people to learn from it. And please subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.